Back home now, and Sydney residents are right now bracing for another thunderstorm after being battered by rain, wind and hail last night. Today, Sydney reporter Jack Hahn joins us from a pretty sunny-looking Parramatta this morning. Jack, the showers, though, haven't stopped for some.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. We are waking up to some sunny skies here in Parramatta, heading for a warm top of 27 degrees, but we will be in for round two later this evening, giving us a little bit of relief from the mercury. But as you mentioned, the rain hasn't even stopped for some, particularly on the far south coast of New South Wales and on the border with regional Victoria. We have checked the gauges for you within the last hour, and the town of Mallacoota in regional Victoria has received a month's worth of rain in just 24 hours, 74 millimetres clock. There's 70 at Green Cape, while closer to town, Bankstown copped 20, and the airport received 14 millimetres when this storm rolled through about 8 o'clock last night. The Bureau tells us that some suburbs in Sydney received half their month's worth of rain in just 20 minutes. That goes to show how fast and furious this storm was. Concerts were cancelled and attendees were sent packing for safety reasons, while there was plenty of leaking roofs right around town. Some drivers forgot the age-old classic, if it's flooded, forget it, going through floodwaters and requiring a rescue. The SES responded more than 200 calls last night, and within the last few hours, another 30 have been made as people wake up and assess the damage around their home. The hardest hit suburb in Sydney was Campbelltown, with 40 calls made this afternoon. We are expecting another thunderstorm to arrive about 2 o'clock when the southerly rolls through. The winds will pick up and the rain will arrive. Jane.
Welcome to summer, Jack. Thank you. Meanwhile, Queensland is on alert for a tropical cyclone predicted to form off the coast of the state's far north in the coming days. It's not expected to make direct impact. Much-needed respite after golf ball-sized hail and 100-kilometre-an-hour winds left more than 10,000 residents without power. Although grey skies haven't provided any relief from the heat, Brisbane is expected to reach 33 degrees today, while Longreach in the state's centre will be the hottest, a sweltering 40 degrees.
Parts of New South Wales are cleaning up this morning after wild weather wreaked havoc overnight. It comes as Queenslanders prepare to sweat through the peak of a heat wave. For the latest, we're joined by Senior Meteorologist Sarah Scully at the Weather Bureau. Sarah, thanks so much for being with us. Which areas were hardest hit?
Well, with the storms last night that passed through Sydney at around 8 or 9pm, and it delivered near 40 millimetres in 20 minutes. So to give you a bit of a perspective, that's almost half the month of December's rainfall in 20 minutes. So it was a big storm with heavy rainfall. And with regards to the heatwave for Queensland, it's mostly northern Queensland that's been experiencing the severe to extreme heatwave conditions this weekend. There's also been a lot of humidity that's been building up along the coastal areas, with afternoon showers and storms bringing brief relief to those high temperatures and sticky conditions. And I should also mention there's a risk of severe thunderstorms today about eastern parts and central parts of Queensland, bringing damaging winds, heavy rainfall and large hail.
Okay, let's go to Victoria. There's a potential for flooding in parts of Victoria. What's the latest there?
Oh, look, there's been a lot of rainfall through eastern Victoria over the last 4 or 5 days. In fact, there's been up to 250 to 350 millimetres received within a 72-hour period, and that resulted in moderate to major flooding. That rain system is now moving out into the Tasman Sea, and we're expecting the floodwaters to continue to ease as the rain has stopped to fall.
OK, and that possible cyclone forming off Queensland's far north coast, how's that looking?
Look, it looks like it's going to be developing into a tropical cyclone, most likely by Tuesday. At this stage, for the next 7 days, it's going to remain well away from the Queensland coast with no impacts to the Queensland coast within this outlook period.
All right. And Sarah, has anyone ever told you you look like Michelle Pfeiffer?
No.
Well, there you go. You do.
I take it as a compliment.
It is a compliment.
Weather chaos has wreaked havoc in Sydney. The city is suddenly drenched by a rapid storm. The Bureau issued a warning at about 7:30 last night, and the rain came flooding in just 2 hours later. A concert and music festival both evacuated, and areas including Parramatta and Eastwood pelted with hail.
Never shelter under temporary event structures, trees or near the stage.
Over 200 calls for help were made to the SES, 36 from Campbelltown alone. The severe storm warning has been cancelled, however. More showers and strong winds are predicted for later on today.